Hello friends, how are you doing? In the video of today, we will learn together how to apply for a visa for Belgium step by step. In this video, we will be explaining the visa policy of this country, how to fill the application form, how and where to apply for the visa, all travel rules due to COVID-19, all the required documents that you will need while applying, and in the end, we'll ask you a question that we will discuss together in the comments. So make sure you watch this video till the end. But before we start, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and if you have any inquiry or question, please write it down there in the comment section below. First, let's explain together the visa policy map of the Schengen area, as the country of today is a part of the Schengen area. So if you are a holder of a passport belong to any country of the Schengen area, or if you are a holder of a visa of any country in the Schengen area, you have a free access to any country inside the Schengen area. And also there are some countries who can get access to Schengen area without visa. For example, countries of all the countries of North America, Australia, United Arab Emirates, Japan, Korea, Malaysia, and many countries in South America. All these countries can get into the Schengen area and stay there for 90 days. For the rest of the world, speaking about all African countries and almost all Asian countries, all these countries must obtain visa before traveling to the Schengen area. And some of these countries like Iran, Iraq, Ethiopia, Somalia, Pakistan, you will need both visas for traveling to the Schengen area or even transiting inside the Schengen area. So the first thing is to fill the online application form. This website, visaonweb.diplomateie.be, is the official website where you can fill the online application form for Belgium. First, if you are not registered, if you don't have an account, click not registered yet and create an account. If you have an account, just log in like that. Okay, so this is the page here, and they are giving you some guides, like first you need to complete and print your electronic application form, then make an appointment, then a logging of the application. So the first thing, you need to create an electronic visa application form. Choose visa type. I'll choose short stay. Okay. Please read the general regulations regarding short stay visa, then click approve. Okay, I have read. You can just read it. Okay, and now you can start filling the application form. Visa application number, status new. Okay. Unimportant. Okay, location, you need to choose your country. Let's say I'm applying from India, for example, and here let's say I'm applying from Goa. Okay, so there is no English language here. Let me select. Okay, there is no English. So let's click unimportant, or if you are familiar with any of those languages, choose any. Let's say French. Okay. Surname. First name. All the stored data must be filled. Okay. First name. Date of birth. For example, place of birth, country of birth, let's choose India, current nationality, India, okay, nationality, after no, male, marital status, single. Nationality, identity number, okay, not important. Add another nationality if there. Travel, a document, okay. Type of document, ordinary passport. The number, date of issue. Okay, let's say that here, January 1st, expiry date. Let's say that year, January 1st also. And issued by which office and the country? India. Home address. Okay. Street. Postal code, not important. City. Country. Let's say India. Telephone number, if there. Email. Okay, current occupation. Okay, employer name, street, country, let's say India, telephone number. Okay, travel data, visa type, short stay, main purpose of the journey, leisure, tourist travel, purpose, choose purpose of travel, tourist travel, additional information, add if there. Okay, member, Belgium, first entry, okay, Belgium, number of entries required, let's say multiple, duration of the intended stay or transit, 30. First intended date of arrival in the Schengen area. Okay. Let's say the end of April. Departure. This one. Means of transport, airplane. Previous fingerprints, no. Host or accommodation. Okay. Person, no, hotel, gives a hotel name, street, country, Belgium, okay, inviting organization, no, there is no inviting organization, okay, and financing of stay, visa applicant, okay, then click here, submit application. City is required. Okay, let's go for this one. Okay, yes, there is another thing also. Yeah, submit application, and now click print application, and now you can print this application. This is the application that you will print, and in the end of this application you need to write the date and the place and to sign it, and this is the application that you will take with you along with all the required documents that we will be speaking about in the end of this video, and submit in the application office. In order to download the visa application form, you can go to the visa information section over here and choose the visa type, for example tourist visa, and once you choose tourist visa here from download the form, you can download all the visa forms from here easily. Speaking about the Schengen visa fees, the fees are 80 euros for adult, and for children between 6 to 12 years of age the fees are 40 euros, and of course you can transfer this amount to your local currency, for example in USD dollars it equals to 87 now, and if you want it also in Indian rupees or in Pakistani rupees or in Egyptian pound or in Indonesian rupiah or in Turkish lira. So the fixed amount is 80 euros, and it changes, of course, depending on your country and depending on the exchange rate right now. So how to apply for this visa? VFS Global is the office responsible of processing and receiving applications for this visa. What you need to do is, in this section, you need to choose your country where you are applying from, if you're applying from India, Pakistan, Egypt, or whatever your country is. And in this section, you need to select the country you are applying for, if you're applying for Austria or Belarus, Bulgaria, Canada, or whatever this country is. And after choosing your selection, click here, take me to the website. Once this page is open in front of you, click here, book now. And then once again, click book now. And in this section, you need to sign in this website and to choose the place of the office inside your country and the perfect time that you need to submit all the documents for this visa. So due to COVID-19, there are some certain rules before traveling to Belgium. For example, you need to be fully vaccinated, and also you need to present a PCR test, a negative PCR test, before traveling, taking at least 48 hours before traveling. And also you need to fill the health declaration form. This is the health declaration form that you need to fill, not more than at least 48 hours before traveling, before entering Belgium. So what are the travel documents that you need to prepare before applying for the visa? Speaking about your passport must be original, and it must not be older than 10 years, with at least 6 months of remaining validity, and with at least 2 blank visa badges for the stamps. In many cases, you will need also a passport photocopy. It might be one copy or more than one, and it's preferred to be colored, and both data badge and photo badge must be shown if separated. In some cases, you might be required to photocopy every single page of your passport, but in general, only the data page and the photo page are the needed ones. Speaking about the personal pictures, you will need at least 2 personal pictures. Sometimes only one is needed, other times 3 pictures are needed, but in general, there are only 2. They must be new, not older than 6 months. It should be clear and show your full face, and it is preferred to be with white background. And you should give normal and neutral expressions. No head or face covering is acceptable except for religious reasons. Speaking about the visa application form, in general cases you need only one copy of the visa application form, but sometimes you might be required to submit 2 copies or even 3. Visa forms are different from a country to another. In general cases, you should print it and fill it manually, but many countries now are providing their application form in an online platform, so you can fill the application form online, and after that you can print it and sign it. Anyway, for the application form, you just fill it as we do in the video. In most of the visa application processes, you will be required to provide a proof of status. For example, if you are an employee, you will have to provide a letter from your employer or from your HR department mentioning your name, your work detail, and your salary. And both address and contact numbers should be mentioned also in that letter. And all letters must have an original signature and a stamp. But in case you are the owner of the company or you run your own business, then your commercial registry and your tax card must be presented. But if you are a student in a school or a college, an enrollment letter should be provided from your university or your school. In some certain cases, you might be applying from a country different than your own country. At that moment, you will need to provide a proof of a legal status, which is a certificate of legal residence in this country. And in some cases, a valid residence visa for this country can be also accepted. You will also need to provide a proof of sufficient funds, which is a bank statement stating your balance for at least 6 months. The original bank statement must show your name and should be signed and stamped by the bank representatives. And remember that cash will not be accepted as a proof of fund. You should also provide a flight reservation. It could be an initial booking, but in some minor cases, you will need to provide a confirmed booking. And remember that this flight reservation must include a return ticket. So let me show you a short tutorial in how to book your flight. And we will use this site, skyscanner.net. Alright, starting with our site, this part is a little bit boring, but we will see what we can do. First, you have to select what type of flight you want: a return flight, like two ways, going and returning, or one way flight, or multi-city. And let me show you an option. If you would like to change the language, you can change it from here. You can choose your language, you can choose your country, you can choose your currency, whatever fits you. All right, so assuming that you have, for example, a travel plan, you're moving between different cities, so you can choose this multi-city option. You can add different cities here and you can adjust your dates, date of arrival, date of departure, and you can book all these tickets at once, which is a very great option. But let's just assume you're moving from only one city to another and you want to have a return flight going and turning back. So assuming you are going from Istanbul, of course you can choose whatever you want, if it's in Istanbul or Surat or whatever airport it is, and returning, what is your destination, where are you going? You're going to Delhi, or you're going to Tbilisi, or whatever, Georgia, Tbilisi. And here you will have to choose your departure date, and here you'll have to choose your return date, and here you have to choose your cabin class. Are you going on economy class, premium economy, business class, first class, or what? And you're an adult, okay, you have any children with you, all right? And here, okay, now you can search flights. Once you click search flights, all the flights will appear in front of you. You can choose whatever flight you want. You can go with the best or the cheapest or the fastest, but it's almost the same here. But of course the price will change depending on the destination, and also will change depending on the date. So let's click this flight, for example, and now will appear in front of us. Let's check the details of this flight. And for this flight, you can book it from different sites. You can book it directly from Skyscanner, or you can go to any of those sites to book it. But yeah, we will book it from Skyscanner. It is the cheapest anyway. Let's click book. But wait, before booking, let's see the details of each flight. Okay, it's a direct flight from Istanbul to Tbilisi, and it's a direct flight from Tbilisi to Istanbul. So by clicking on these arrows, you can see the details of each flight. Let's click book, and here you can see the dates. Okay, you're going, departure, okay, going, returning, and the date. And now click book. So once you click booking, your trip appears in front of you and the total price appears in euros. Why? Because they set their prices here in euro in Skyscanner. So now you can see the details. Okay, you have one cabin page, you have one checked page. Now let's click next and see more about the details and the checkout. So in the end, what you need to do is to add a contact details, which is an email and a phone number, and after that you will have to add a traveler, which is your name, your middle name, your last name, and in the end you will have to click pay. And by clicking pay, you can do your payment, and congratulations, you booked your flight. You will also need to provide a proof of accommodation. It could be a confirmed hotel reservation, or an invitation from a host in this country, or an invitation from an organization you are visiting in this country. For a hotel or hostel, an initial booking is acceptable, but in some minor cases, you might need to provide a confirmed booking. And anyway, the name of your hotel must be mentioned, and the address and the contact number. But in case you are invited by a person, either the letter of invitation should be mailed directly to the embassy, or to be submitted by you, accompanied by a copy of the passport of that inviting person. There are different sites that you can use to book a hotel or a hostel, but let me show you a fast tutorial how to book your hostel from booking.com. So this is our site, booking.com. First, you have to specify where are you going. Let's say I'm going to Istanbul. I want to have Istanbul. Okay, I'm traveling. Okay, for example, check in, okay, let's say at that date, and check out, let's say at that date, and I want one adult, one room, and let's click search. All right, by clicking search, okay, they are giving me all the locations and they are giving me the price here in Egyptian pound. Let's assume I would like to change my currency. I will change my currency from here. I will choose USD dollars. And now the prices are here, USD dollars, for the full period. Those things in this site will help you for your choice. You can filter by your budget or your popular filter or health and safety, whatever interests you more, star rating, whatever it is. But there is an interesting option here also that you can arrange all of these things depending on price if you are a low budget traveling person. So we can rearrange it according to price lowest first, and let's see the price lowest first for the full period. And you can see that we are having very good prices in somehow okay good quality. Also we can see, also we can check for better quality. Okay, still good price for very good quality. Let's check availability. Okay, I like that one. It looks old and only 5 beds left at this price. So you are booking a bed in dormitory and one bunk bed. See availability. Once you click see availability, the whole apartment or the whole place appears in front of you. You can see all the details of this place, and you can here start choosing the availability, like you can like change the dates. And the most popular facilities here, that non-smoking rooms, free Wi-Fi, 24 hours front desk terrace, and heating also, because sometimes Istanbul gets very cold. They are also giving you here some selections, like for example bed in male dormitory room, and you can see all the details here, like okay, air conditioning, free Wi-Fi, shower, toilet, heating, hair dryer, and of course if you want any other option like comfort, double or twin room, or classic double or twin room, or standard treble room, whatever you want. But let's just go for the cheapest and select only one bed. You can select of course more than one bed, and they give you different things like free cancellations and no prepayment needed. You can pay directly at the property. So if you, in case you would like to cancel it, they are giving you a specific time and a specific date. In that date, till that date, you are free to, you can cancel this booking for free. Just click I will reserve. Once you click I will reserve here, you are filling your details. They are giving all the booking details. It is for 4 nights and this price is $35. And here you will have to enter your details, all your details, and bed in male dormitory room. Okay, you'll have to give your full name and if you have any special request or something, and also here give your arrival time. So you have just to review all these parts, and in the end you will click final details. By clicking final details, you will review again all your details and you will confirm your booking. Once your booking is confirmed, you will receive an email in your email like that, stating the check-in details and the check-out detail and the duration of the stay, the phone number and the address of the place and all the details. And this is the page that you will have to print and take with you to the embassy while applying for the visa. Many countries also, especially the Schengen area countries, require you to provide a traveling insurance, and you have to be careful and to apply through the companies that are accepted officially in these countries. For example, in case for Schengen area countries, there are some certain specifications for this travel insurance, like the insurance coverage must be at least 30,000 euros, and in general cases you can apply for this insurance online. Now let's look together as a travel insurance company. Those are some travel insurance companies. You can use any of those websites to apply for the travel insurance, but since I know that travel insurance is a little bit confusing for most of people, I selected two companies and we will see together how to apply for travel insurance through those two companies. Applying for travel insurance is quite confusing for many people, but here I selected the site europeinsurance.eu, and let's see how to apply for travel insurance. First, you have to select your main destination in Europe, which is, I selected France, the start date, the end date. Let's say you're just staying for 1 month and you want this insurance for 1 month, and here you write your date of birth, then get a quota. Okay, so now there are two types of travel insurance. The first one is basic and it costs 19 the 19 euros per month, and it covers more than 60,000 euros, which is required because for travel insurance you have to apply for something more than or equals to 30,000 euros. So I will select this one, and here if you want to extend, but just let's keep it like that for this basic one. I will select it over here, and now I will have to fill my details, the insured person, my name, and the policy holder also, if it is the same person, though the same also details, my own details, and important statements, just some statements, and in the end you will get to the payment. So this travel insurance which will cover more than 60,000 euros for 1 month, it's just only 19 euros. Let's check another site, which is axaschengen.com, which is quite expensive site, and here they give you different periods, like for Schengen low cost, Schengen Europe travel, Schengen multi-trip, get a quote. Okay, so for the prices here, okay, let's first you need to click get a quota over here for the cheapest one. Okay, and here they will ask you the Schengen low cost, they will ask you about the start date and the end date of your travel. So my first date is this one, all right, 12, and my last date, let's say, will be 11th of April, also for 1 month, and this one for 31 days, and it's a little bit, it's not a little bit expensive, it is expensive, and it covers only up to 30,000 euros, but you know the difference is sometimes about the rate of the company, and also the categories they are covering in the travel insurance. But here I'm just showing you how to choose, how to apply, because this is, because choosing the category, the options, is something depending on you. But many people are just having some problems, what is the travel insurance, how to apply through the travel insurance. So all these other details I will leave to you. I'm just showing you how to apply through the site and what is the real cost of the travel insurance. By saying 30,000 euros, we don't mean that you should have this balance in your bank or to prove that you have it, because some people think so, those who are not really having experience with travel insurance. Then here you click continue, and after you click continue, you click here for the subscriptions. You will have to fill all your details, and after filling your details, you will make your payment, and in the end you will get a confirmation of your travel insurance. And that's how you apply for travel insurance through this website.